From its effect on humanity to how it would affect the Earth itself, join me as I reveal to you what would happen if the sun suddenly disappeared from the sky. Number 6. Mass hysteria. I think it's important to start at the zero hour of such an event, don't you? Because let's be honest, if the sun were to randomly disappear from the sky above, a lot of people would go out and panic. Or would they? Well, it depends on how much they know about the world and the sun itself. After all, while the sun is such an important part of our solar system, our planet, and our lives, a lot of people still don't understand all there is to know about the sun. So it goes to reason that at least at first, people will be concerned, but not fully understand what's going on, and that itself would be a logical and fair reaction. Better to be worried and curious than go into mass hysteria to start. But naturally, the moment the sun disappears from the sky, the people who know that this isn't supposed to be happening are going to be looking for answers as to what is going on, and those in the fields of news are going to be trying to get answers from scientists so they can report it to the world itself, which actually would be a very bad thing. Because once the world at large figures out that the sun disappearing truly is a bad thing, they're going to lose it. After all, humans are very instinctive and superstitious creatures. They will likely think that this is a sign of an impending apocalypse or a religious rebirth or something else that may cross their minds. And when people lose it, people suffer. And that's really. So it's going to tax the police, the armies of the world, and more to try and maintain order while some semblance of understanding is had. Granted, I wouldn't even them that perish because the truth would be very hard to swallow. Because while it may not be a religious apocalypse, it technically would be the beginning of the end of the world. And it would start in the very opposite way that one religious text says it all began. Number 5. No natural light. Let me ask you a very basic question. What do you think the sun does? You'll no doubt think it keeps you warm, gives you something to look for in the sky, and various other simple and basic things. But in truth, it goes well beyond that. The sun's effect on our world truly starts with the fact that it illuminates all of it, even when you don't realize that it does. So if the sun were to suddenly disappear from our skies, the light that it gives out to the world would go out, and thus basically put us into complete darkness. Now, unlike the sun suddenly disappearing, the total darkness event wouldn't happen right away. How so? Well, the way light travels takes time, and thus it would take that amount of time for light to stop reaching Earth. But no matter the time, the Earth will go dark. Some of you right now may be saying that this wouldn't be true, as the sun isn't the only entity in the sky right now that emits light, and that's both true and false. While the moon and stars do have a light to them, it's not exactly made on their own. The moon itself is a celestial body. That's why we see it in our sky. However, the only reason we see it is because of the sun. This is due to the fact that the moon's surface is reflective. The moon is covered in a dust called regolith, and it has a reflective property to it that allows the sun's rays to make it shine. That's why there's such a thing as the dark side of the moon that is always dark, because the sun's rays can't reach it thanks to the position and rotation in connection with the sun itself. If you're piecing together what I'm saying, then you know that if the sun disappeared from our sky, we wouldn't be able to see the moon because nothing would reflect off the surface. That goes double for any stars and planets in the sky. For we only saw them because of the sun reflecting their own lights and emissions that they send out in space. The sun plays a big part in our world seeing anything above it. So without the sun, we lose a big part of our world in a sense. Notice though that the title of this entry is No Natural Light. And I meant that in the sense that humanity has created its own lighting system via electricity. So we would be able to see around our own world for the most part. The light of the sun and even the moon and stars allows us to see things in more detail when in areas that don't have electricity, like in forests or in fields and such. So if we were to try and traverse an area like that, you'd need another light source. Traveling throughout the world would be more difficult without natural light, and the lack of natural light would affect all manner of animals and plants, as I'll reveal later. So that's one major reason you should hope the sun never disappears. But it's not the only reason. Number 4. No light, no plants. While it's only natural for us to wonder what would happen to humanity if the sun were to disappear in the sky, a more critical and important question that needs to be asked is, what would happen to the plants of the world? If you're wondering why we should be asking this, the answer is photosynthesis, the process of which plants make food for themselves and grow. And this is a problem because if there's no sunlight, then photosynthesis immediately stops, with very few exceptions. And as hopefully you all know, if you don't have plants, many food sources in the world almost immediately start dying out. To be fair, humanity could help sustain plant life on some scale, and plants like trees and certain underwater plants would be able to survive on their own, but only for a short time. And the lights that would be needed to, say, illuminate a whole field of crops would be very costly, and it's no guarantee that it would work. Thus, planets will start dying at an alarming rate, and that'll just be the start of another major catastrophe. For humans aren't the only things that need plants to survive. Animals do too. Some more than others, even. Herbivores would be the type of animal most affected, as literally all of their food supply will have dried up, or never been born. With no food, they'll all die, which will cause cascading effects on all the ecosystems they are in. And any time a massive ecosystem is hurt, we all suffer. Even the loss of a single animal species on our planet would cause lots of harm. Now imagine that across all 7 continents. Okay, 6. Antarctica probably doesn't have to worry about grasses and other plant life on its surface, but the other 6 will be affected. And with each plant that dies that causes an animal to die, our world becomes a lot smaller in the life index. But that's not all the loss of plants would do to the planet. Plants give life back to the Earth itself. It's a process that is very important, or else the world will end up being barren. So imagine a world without even the most basic of plant life, like grass. It would cause another cascade of problems that would affect humankind. For example, oxygen. Plants help make oxygen. They take in the carbon dioxide in the air and recycle it into oxygen we can breathe. Plants are essential for the balance of our atmosphere. Without them, the carbon dioxide levels in the atmosphere will grow at such a rate that it will eventually kill us from not being able to breathe. You may not think about it when you plant them, but plants are a vital part of our lives, and without them, we would very slowly die. Allow that's not the only way we could die from lack of sunlight. Number 3. It's cold planet. Without the sun, we lose a lot of things. That much is known. But one thing you might not think about right away is the fact that without the sun in the sky, our temperature on Earth is going to be drastically affected. After all, the light the sun brings also transports warmth. So without that constant source of warmth, our planet suffers. To be fair, we won't insta-freeze. That's not how it works. Not unlike you can't freeze a meal just by putting it in the freezer for a few seconds or a minute. In fact, most scientists agree that if the sun went out only for a day, not much would happen. Our atmosphere is capable of holding its own heat, which is actually magnified thanks to our use of fossil fuels, hence global warming. And so it goes to reason that our planet would be able to last, temperature-wise, for a little bit. After about a week of no sunlight or warmth, though, the average temperature of Earth would be around 0 degrees Fahrenheit. That's not only cold, that's below freezing, which would allow a bunch of ice and snow to form on the planet, both on the land and the oceans themselves. Scientists believe that in a year's time, the average temperature on Earth would be minus 100 degrees Fahrenheit, and that's when the ocean would freeze on the surface more than likely, which would be another nail in the coffin of the planet because we rely on the oceans for many things, and if they're frozen on top, it'll lead to many disasters. Many who study the possibility of the sun going out feel that if humanity needed a solution, we could simply tunnel look to the inside of our planet and use the Earth's core to try and heat ourselves, not unlike how many geothermal vents do in the oceans themselves. That potentially could work, but there are many issues with that, not the least of which that it would need to be done for the whole planet, and humanity would need to be close enough together to feel that kind of warmth. And do recall, this would only be one problem that would need to be solved in order to save our planet. Humanity may be resigned to a literal cold fate should the sun go out. However, there is also a chance that we may not even reach the freezing point due to another principle of nature. Number 2. Nothing to orbit. There are many ways that the Earth would be affected by the disappearance of the sun. But one thing that many would forget about is that we actually orbit the sun. We're constantly in its gravitational pull. Thus why we and all the other planets and moons and rocks in the solar system, without their own momentum, is pulled by it. So you need to ask yourselves, what happens if that gravity, that pull, that binding force, stops binding our planet? With a guiding body, our planet stays exactly where it is within its orbit. However, without one, Earth would literally start careening through the stars in whatever direction it was heading before the sun itself went out. I'm sure I don't have to spell out all the havoc that would wreak on our planet, but I'll give you some hope. We wouldn't have to worry about it for long, because we wouldn't last long without our orbit around the sun. Because without that binding force, there's nothing stopping us from colliding into other things in our solar system. As you might know, there are asteroid belts and comets and other stars and planets out there. The sun was actually protecting us from hitting those things via its orbit paths. But without one, it's going to be a game of galactic pinball, except we're not going to just bounce off unscathed. For example, if we were to collide with an asteroid, it could literally wipe out our planet in a fraction of a minute. Or worse yet, we could literally collide with an entire planet, one that would absorb us, burn us, gas us, or another variety of things. So between all of these factors, I think you can admit that if the sun were to suddenly disappear, we wouldn't last very long. Number 1. Nothing to fear, yet. I'm sure that by the end of this video, you're likely curious what the chances are that this happens to Earth, especially since certain shows talk about this. And even a Marvel comic miniseries, Avengers: No Surrender, actually depicted a version of this happening. But here's the thing, while everything we talked about is fairly accurate, or as accurate as it can be given the idea that the sun would just vanish, we don't actually have to worry about this happening. For the sun to suddenly disappear would take a force quite unknown to our universe. You could even call it a god-level event, if you will, as the sun is comprised of energy that would take a lot to snuff it out. Not to mention, one of the ways that stars die is go supernova or explode. So if either of those things happened to our sun, the Earth would likely be dead in seconds. And the likelihood of that happening is slim because our sun is actually pretty young. It's got a couple billion years before anything like that happens. So for now, you can relax. The sun isn't going anywhere yet. So what did you think about these things that would happen if the sun went and disappeared from our sky? Which one do you personally think is the worst of the bunch? Or are you not worried at all about this?